praise the Lord. My God, I believe God is set to do something in your life right now. You are not seated here by accident. So what am I saying? Call your friends, call your beloved ones, sit down because you're going to be blessed. Just hook onto this program. I'll be back to pray with you.
The greatest gift is the gift of salvation. Of hawking business, you don't need it. Stay and serve God. When the woman heard, she had the right information. Those of you who have it, you better thank God. Most people are somewhere now because they did not have the right information. They saw themselves in the wrong zone. They are locked up. I plead with you. If you found one, why not nurture it? Keep it. Grow in the place. Grow and see what God will do in your life. Are you sure you are listening to what I'm saying? This is the end time. A lot of things. Listen to me. The Bible says the ninth cometh. We are in the ninth hour. This is the ninth hour. This is the ninth hour. A lot of thieves have entered. A lot of things have entered. A lot of signboard. The fact that they are quoting the scripture does not mean they are in the picture. Am I communicating here? Check and try the spirit, whether it's of God. But why do you go checking when you already have one? Am I communicating? Why are you gambling with your salvation? You know, sometimes when I watch why some people do what they do, I ask myself, say, maybe they were not so close to death and sin like some of us were. We're living with sin. We're close to sin. And when we found salvation, we began to thank God. We gave God the glory. I remember for days wept, and I began to ask God, who am I that you counted me so faithful to serve you? Who am I? So there are days like, I just feel like worshiping God, nothing to say, I just keep rolling on the floor. Lord, who am I? A mere clay. When last have you ever done that with your salvation? When last have you ever done that? So what we have is a bunch of people who come to court and they complain. They complain instead of thinking of complying, how to lift up the work of God on earth. No, they are thinking because they are only, don't mind all these churches, they are all fake. I'm not doubting. The fake means there's original. And when you find original, you better sit down. You better sit down because you may be talking and you talk against God. And you know what? God will kill you by himself. That's God. Or he call you home. God can use anybody. He cannot use a discouraged person. Anytime a man is discouraged, God can use the joy bow of an axe to defeat Philistines. God can bring water out of the rock when there is no water for Israelites. God can dry the Red Sea when the Red Sea stand on the way of his children. God can dry up Jordan when the Jordan say nobody will cross. Am I communicating here? But God can never, never use a discouraged vessel. When you are discouraged, you are on your own until you encourage yourself in the Lord. 1 Samuel chapter 30. And David encouraged himself in the Lord. You must get to the level where you encourage yourself. God gave you salvation. Your mate died. Your mate died. How much are you spending? How much are you paying to keep yourself alive? Go and check where some are in the name of protection that you are getting free of charge. Am I communicating here? Do you think occultic people will say well about the church? No. Do you think somebody who is far from church will say well about the church? He's going to say all kinds of things. He's going to write some things on the pages of newspaper so that you can read it and contaminate your spirit. But by the time you read it, then you come to church with that mind saying, they said what I read in the paper yesterday, the person who wrote it, not be SKD, Senior King of Devil. Is it not fulfilling scripture? Did they not call Jesus Beelzebub? Are you sure you are hearing what I'm saying here? That's the truth. You better keep your faith alive. Keep your faith alive. Child of God, me holding microphone here, I smoke Igbo with fella. I was a bad guy. I'm telling you now, make you look my face well. I smoke Igbo. Says how they do am. I not be novice. And they take and sleep, and they take and wake up, and they go and go to toilet. If I chop, it go in my right hand. I take and they swallow food. If food hook my throat, I'll smoke it, bro. Take and swallow. They come out for my ear, come out for my nose. On my socks everywhere a day. I'm just trying, you know, I'm making this introduction to let you know the worst sinner can be the best saint. Let nobody write you off. I'm letting you know that I preach, I don't condemn people. I'm letting you know that God can use you. But you must not remain the way you are. You can't come to church and remain the same. You were living in sin, but you came to church now. You are now managing sin. You must be able to tell yourself enough is enough. Don't preach to let you know, well, I am righteous, that's why God put me. I was not righteous. The grace of God found me. The mercy of God found me. But shall we continue in sin that the grace may abide? No, God forbid.
Number 7, finally, she did something with her information. She got information. She did something with her information. My question is, what are you doing with your information? She did something with her own. Every time you hear this word, what do you do with it? She did something with it. She did something with it. Lift up your hands as I pray with you. Father, in the name that is above every other name, even the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, I hereby decree today, any form of delay, satanic embarrassment, any form of issue, I command that issue to expire. Yeah. I command the issue to expire. Yeah. I say, let that issue expire. Yeah. I say, let that issue expire. Yeah. Let God give you testimony. Yeah. Let Him give you victory. Yeah. It is victory at last. Yeah. Your celebration has started. Yeah. Your victory has started. Yeah. You are coming with a new song, yeah, a new testimony. A new level of joy. Joy is breaking forth in your life. Testimony is breaking forth in your life. It is your season to laugh. It's your season to smile. Let me hear a better amen.
Wow, what an awesome message. I know you'll be richly blessed. And you know what? Let me tell you, in case you have not accepted Jesus as your Lord and personal Savior, don't forget the time is running out. Why not simply say with me now, Jesus, I am a sinner. Have mercy on me. From now onward, I will serve you all the days of my life. I confess you as my Lord. If you have prayed that prayer, just seal it with an amen. Now I bless you and I command things to favor you. I command healing in your body. I command healing in your home. I command healing in your business. I command healing all over from the crown of your head to the sole of your foot right now. Receive that healing in your body, in your system. Receive it now. I come against sickness. I come against disease. I come against arthritis. Lose that man. Lose that woman. Lose that boy. Lose that girl. And let them go now. In Jesus' name. Beloved, I bless you.